Hi, I'm Dr. Mukesh Gupta, obstetrician gynecologist from Lenest, Malad. Welcome to the series, 40 tips to 40 weeks. I hope you've seen the earlier ones of the first 2 weeks. This is the third week that we are talking about and the tip for the third week. So what is the tip here? Okay, here it is. Survival of the fittest, meaning only the fit survive. So the primary fact about evolution is that only the fittest will survive and rest will not get the opportunity to do well. And that is what happens in the third week. Well, in true words, the pregnancy is actually starting from the third week, because at the end of the second week, the ovulation has happened. And once the timed intercourse has happened at the beginning of the third week, the pregnancy just starts. What is happening now is millions of sperms have entered into the vagina, of which one of them is only capable of actually fertilizing the ovum in the fallopian tubes. So once the fertilization takes place in the fallopian tube, what happens is that the sperm and the egg, which have come together to form the zygote starts developing in the fallopian tube and travels back to the uterine cavity and gets implanted there. For some reason, if it doesn't happen, it gets stuck there. And that problem is called as ectopic pregnancy. So there's the first thing that we need to understand, that the fertilization is happening in the tube and not in the uterus, and this journey has to happen. Sometimes at this time you may have a little spotting, that's called as actually implantation spotting, because the embryo is getting implanted and that particular site there might be a little bleeding, which is also not very scary. Don't be worried about it. A little bit of spotting at this time is not going to harm the baby if the baby is conceived at this time. The next thing that happens here is that once the implantation happens, then the pregnancy starts developing and growing inside the uterine cavity. Now, this is the time when you're truly pregnant, but it is still not the right time to be able to detect the pregnancy, because the pregnancy is detected because of A, the symptoms, which are not going to happen now, B, the hormones which are changing, like the HCG hormone, either in the blood or the urine, which is so low at the moment that it is not going to be picked up actually in your blood or urine. So when you look at the third week, so this is what is the main important thing, that although you are pregnant, but nobody knows that you are pregnant. So, and we really don't know whether your fertilization is good enough or not. But as I told you about the tip, survival of the fittest, remember, only if you are fit and healthy will the pregnancy continue. It's a very basic thing. For the pregnancy to grow, the quality of the gametes which are coming together from the male and the female should be of good quality and the fittest ones. Once they have formed, it should get implanted in the uterine cavity, and the lining of the uterus should also be fit enough to hold it, so there should not be any infections. And third thing is that the environment around it, that is the minerals, vitamins, there's no exposure of toxins in your body, only then can your pregnancy grow better. It's like grow a plant. The seed should be good, the soil should be good, and the other aspects, that is the sunlight, the water, etc., should be favorable. Only then will the plant grow. Similarly, even the baby is part of the mother nature, will only develop fit and healthy if everything is around is good. So it is a good time for you to look back at the health of your body, and if possible, if you have not already found a good doctor, figure out and look at the preconceptional planning. Please do a check again if you have already taken your vaccines, especially the flu vaccine, by this time or not. If not, then it is a good time to take it beforehand, before you actually get pregnant. Well, this is the final thing. What you don't need to do: no exposure to toxins, no exposure to alcohol, tobacco, or similar such thing which is going to harm your baby. No exposure to drugs, prescription drugs, like, for example, retinin, AAN, all those things in a higher level. If you are on any medications, for example, anticonvulsant or any depressant or similar such thing, please check with your doctor what needs to be done about them. Tell them that you are planning a baby, so they will change them into something which is safer for you and the baby. Lastly, don't forget to meet your dentist at this time, because you don't want to go to your dentist when you're pregnant. Get the thing sorted out beforehand. Lastly, remember, you will not be able to detect whether you're pregnant or not at this time, right? And not every time that your partner is having a relation with you will you get pregnant. It's mother nature. Not every time that you sow the seed will the seed grow into a plant. Not every time the plant grows into a tree, and not every time the tree will give fruits, and not all the fruits borne by the tree are worth eating. Similarly, every time you have contact, it's not necessary for you to get pregnant. If there is a possibility that the implantation will happen, there might be a chance that there might be abortion happening if the pregnancy is not fit enough or if there is some other problem. And not every child is going to go into healthy if we are not staying fit ourselves. So remember, survival of the fittest. Stay fit, stay healthy. Thank you very much.